Are you prepared to go blind? If you are, congratulations, you won't have a problem moving to Mars. We've all heard about Mars, an alternate planet. People are actually considering sharing resources from other planets and even living on them to escape climate change and all its destruction. Multimillionaire Elon Musk even imagined that by 2024, the first group of humans would be sent to live on Mars. But whether that life will be yours or your children's, he wants to take us to Mars, right? So what's stopping us? Well, astronauts have been returning from long space missions with eye diseases that threaten to blind them permanently. And honestly, I don't know if space had its heart broken by a man and is seeking revenge, because this potential permanent damage to the eyes hasn't affected a single female astronaut so far. It's been all men. What's worse is even NASA doesn't know what's going on. So here's what I'm thinking. I can't go to space to study this, so I need to bring zero gravity to me. Easy enough. I do this by putting you on a bed and tilting it so that the blood in your body would rush towards your head. This is exactly how blood would flow in space, where there's no gravity to pull the blood to your feet. Now, if I measured your blood pressure while you're in that position, I'd have an idea of how much blood is entering your eye, whereas through your eye pressure, I'd know the amount leaving it. The balance between these two is critical to ensure your eye remains healthy. But when you're in that position, imbalance occurs because blood rushes to your eyes faster than it rushes out of them. My theory is that the eye's inability to drain blood fast enough will lead to an increase in its blood pressure when tilted. And that's fine when you're laying in this position for a few hours on a lab table. But as an astronaut, you live with this pressure difference for every minute of every day as long as you're in space. My idea is that the long-term effect of this pressure on the optic nerve is what's slowly leading to irreversible damage, which could cause blindness. Through my study, NASA can better understand the cause of these sight-threatening changes in astronauts. They could then prevent this outcome with strategies that restore the pressure balance. Remember, through space exploration, we've already gained access to TV, weather forecasts, and now I'm telling you there's potential for a new home. Imagine how much more we could do if we could explore deeper into space without worrying about going blind. The kind of possibilities we'd be opening up for future generations who are terrified of the consequences of climate change. Who knows? Maybe some of you will be part of that first group on Mars, a part of something greater. But until we figure this out, I'll ask those of you interested in visiting space once more. Are you prepared to go blind? Thank you.